So what are we up to today, Gordon?
Today we're looking at the TS100 soldering iron, specifically for soldering LED tape.
So why are you not recommending the soldering iron we've seen in previous video presentations on the channel?
Okay, well this is quite an older model, Gary. It's been around for some time.
It must have been in your collection of tools if it's an old tool, I would
say. Yeah, it's a Metcal soldering iron. It's fantastic, but probably built for people who are going to be doing thousands and thousands of joints day in, day out, not so someone who's going to be doing lead tape, possibly on site. So it's a bit bulky, and possibly most of all, it's quite expensive.
So you're saying you found this TS100 that will probably be that nice compromise for somebody who's doing occasional soldering joints of LED?
Yeah, so I did some research, and this TS100 kept coming up in the various videos and reviews, and it's available from an online retailer with next day delivery for free. So I thought I'd get one.
Okay, well, whip it out of the box then and let's have a look at what you have got.
Yeah, so I actually bought a full kit that included the power supply and probably the world's smallest soldering iron holder. So I don't think they come with the standard kit, they were the deluxe version.
I'll just give you a little bit of a reference there against my thumb. Yes, that is microscopic, I would suggest.
Yeah, so this comes in a box, some instructions. Obviously we'll never read them, so we'll come back to them later. So here's the kit itself. So here's the main handle. It's got the electronics in. This is a temperature controlled iron, so I think when we set it we can actually set the temperature here.
Okay.
And here's the tip. So this slightly different to a traditional solder iron. It's actually a tip and heating element combined in one unit.
All right, so if I had to get a different tip on it, I'd actually get the whole thing to replace?
Yeah, and I believe they're reasonably priced compared to our legacy soldering iron. I don't think that's a major operation. So
okay, can you put it together for me?
Gonna put it together. So it comes with this tiny little hex key, and it looks like there's some spare screws in there because they are quite small, so you probably lose them.
We probably will.
Yeah, mm-hmm. So I'll just
Wind that one back
so I can see the barrel's clear in there now.
Right.
So I'm going to put the solder iron in with the tip facing.
That's always handy, yes, yeah. I would suggest, yeah.
So, oh, it's
well,
quite
pretty nice. It looks like something maybe James Bond would keep in a top pocket, wouldn't he, for an inventive emergency soldering.
Yeah, could be. Yeah, could have a poison dart in there. But actually, speaking of darts, it has a feel of a dart, really. You know, brings back memories of Jockey Wilson and Jim Bourne, possibly. You know,
okay. Never heard of any of those dart players. I'm more a Phil the Power Taylor myself.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. So we're locked and loaded by the let's use the world's smallest soldering iron.
Do you want
a holder? So yeah.
Do you want to tap up, top up with a Taplin spring, Gary?
A little drop of the liquid refreshment. Okay. So don't think we need many droplets here. So let's just punch a little bit into.
I'll get rid of the packaging.
Okay. There we go. So yes, in it goes. We've moistened the pad, and we are now ready to go.
So this is the power supply. So the power port for this on the back. If you want to have
a look. Just give me my camera.
So I say you can buy the power supply separately. The one thing I don't like about this lead is PVC.
Right.
So if you leave the iron sort of, if it accidentally touches there, you're going to end up melting chunks out of it.
Okay.
Where our legacy iron has a silicon lead on it.
Okay.
So this take a DC input between 12 and 24 volts.
Right.
So if you were clever and you wanted to be on site, you could probably make a portable power supply to connect to with a couple of gel lead acid batteries or something like that.
Okay. So you're going to fire this up, and you think we're going to be able to see the temperature?
Straight away.
Let's have a look.
It's asking me to press.
We'll press something that we haven't read the instructions for. So you'll press both buttons.
Press the one there. Nearest there. So there we go. 25. Oh, it's off.
Wow. So we're saying the temperature's climbing from 25 already.
Yeah.
What temperature do we need it for this Osram tape?
So the Osram tape. So they're recommending instructions 350 degrees.
Right.
So I'm going to have to increase that here. So let's get. Oh, there you go. Press that there, and you can see I've come up with the temperature setting, so I'm going to dial that up to
350. So
let's see if that goes back off.
That'll climb to 350. Are we at 350 now? Oh no,
it's off now. Little arrow saying it's going up.
Wow, so that now is at 350 already.
Yeah, so Osram give you that instruction, 350 degrees on the solder iron, and the maximum touch time you can be in there doing your joint is 5 seconds. So that relates back to the power of the iron. Has it got enough oomph to get the heat in there? This is a 65 watt iron,
right,
at 24 volts. So you can obviously probably less when you're at a lower voltage.
So just get that to recap. So we needed it at 350 degrees for this tape, and we can only hold the soldering on the tape for a maximum of 5 seconds.
Yeah.
And we covered that in a video that we did on connecting to LED strip, where we looked at both the solder and the insulation displacement. And we recommend, if you get a chance after this video, maybe checking that one out.
Yeah, and there's even a hidden video of Gary having an attempt at soldering to have a look at. So that's worth a look. So
it isn't. So you're going to turn that, so we'll come back onto the roving cam and have a look. What you've got down here. So
we've got some heat.
It up.
Let's see. Just bring in our solder.
Okay, so
people ask us about solder as well. So this is a thin gauge solder with no lead in it. You can't really have a lead solder in Europe anymore. Okay. So that melted pretty quick.
Okay.
I'm not going to use my little Brillo pad here.
Wow, that looks like
to clean the tip off.
Something that may have appeared in a science fiction film back in 1977, I would think. That looks like a droid to me.
Okay. Or your mum's sink, Gary. Okay. It's a Brillo pad.
Okay.
So we've got some LED tape here on the solder mate. So we like the solder mate because it holds the LED tape in place.
Okay.
And it has this nice heat sink behind it to make sure you don't put too much heat into the plastic and melt it. So let's just try and tin the pads up first and see how we can do it. Now the pads on the Osram one are quite large pads.
Yeah.
So, wow, that was quick.
So that's tinning the pads first, and that's a technique that's expected. Osram like people to tin their pads first.
Yeah.
So you were on there less than 5 seconds.
Yeah.
Solder melted really quickly, and you're now ready to introduce the positive and negative conductors.
Yeah. So I'm just going to rest the soldering iron in there. So the problem is this is quite lightweight, so that's where that stand isn't possibly the best.
Yeah. Right. So you get yourself prepared there, and obviously we'll be looking in closely. But again, check out those videos in this series on LED strip, where we look at reasonably priced LED strip, we look at cutting LED strip, and in this case we're not necessarily giving a masterclass on soldering as we've done in a previous video. It's all about this TS100 soldering iron. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Right, I'll get the cam ready. So here we go then. So we're coming back in, and you're going to do the positive conductor first.
Yeah.
With a maximum of 5 seconds in order to get that connected.
I've done that. Wow.
Right, okay, let's have a little look in there. Let's not have a cheat. Right, okay,
yeah,
that looks
probably not my best joint in the world, but bear in mind it is hard to actually solder on camera and keep your mitts out of the camera angle.
Well, we can all come up with
that's my excuse.
Yeah, well, it's the one you're using. So we're going in now with the negative, okay, in order to make that connection. So a little bit of fiddling around, just making sure you get it placed correctly on top of that soldered pad before you come back in with the soldering. What's your feelings at the minute on the soldering? It seems to
it's good. I mean, it's very lightweight. If you're used to very lightweight, I mean, you might slip. I wouldn't be careful you don't slip along there and touch the element.
Right, okay.
A little guard there might have been.
A little shroud. Stopping
just
your hand.
The shroud.
Give us a second to get in with the actual close-up cam. So let's see if you're any better this time. I don't think you could be any worse, probably. You're chasing it around the pad there, I see. So
I'll just kick that over.
Okay, so let's have a...
And then people will be saying, oh, your fingers are close.
We had that last time.
I've burnt my fingers loads of times on solar hands, so...
Okay, considering that's, pretty much live on cam, I think that's a pretty reasonable effort. But of course, as always, the proof's in the pudding, whether it will actually energise. In other words, can Gordon liven this up?
All right,
and we see that these LEDs illuminate. Okay, so you strip those ends back off. So lots of positives here, I would suggest. We like the fact that you got up to temperature 350 degrees, very rapid.
That was quick.
Yeah, that was quick. Maybe we'd like to see a shroud, maybe similar to what we'd see on GS38 test leads, wouldn't we, where you're stopping yourself slipping towards the live parts, stopping yourself slipping towards the heated elements.
And if I was doing it, I'd try and get a lighter sort of silicon lead that's a bit more flexible.
Right.
And a bit longer, actually. But there we go.
Oh. It's always best to be lucky, I would suggest, in life, isn't it? So, that was done. Again, remember, it's a review of the soldering iron, not necessarily Gordon's technique for soldering. So we've done that in a one-up. But the proof will be in the pudding when you do it for the second time. And I've got here, I've done this on a previous video, some reasonably priced LED strip. And now these are, let's get the cam on. Let me show everybody what these look like. Now, we are talking about microscopic terminals in which you've got a solder onto.
Mm.
Okay, so we'll love a challenge at eFIXX. So I'll set this up. while you prepare yourself, and let's see if the soldering iron with that very small tip, probably this will be its home turf, I would suggest, isn't it? Nice tiny dots in which to make your connections onto.
So if I was doing the Osram tip all day, I would pick a bigger tip size.
Okay.
But not with this one.
But no, I think you might be all right. And I wouldn't suggest they need perhaps tinning. Maybe tin the tips of the actual conductors.
I'm going to tin them.
Oh, you're going to get this. Come in and have a look then. They are microscopic. There we go. I don't know who's shaking the most, me or you, I think. Wow, that was wow, it was made for that, wasn't it?
It was made for that, so let's see if we can get this.
They are two perfect beads of solder. Okay, so it's all down to you now to obviously make all the necessary errors now as you position your conductors in. You've not got a lot of room to get those onto either. So Gordon's fiddling away now, trying to make sure he lines those up right. The solder mate comes in really handy now. Imagine trying to hold both of those into position. That would be, I would suggest, a very tricky job. But now this is it. This is the pressured moment. Okay, here you go.
Shaking around today.
I'm shaking as well.
There we go.
No way.
Shaking helps sometimes, Gary, on soldering.
That was brilliant.
That was one done.
Yeah, that's held on. Okay. Let's go for the next one. So one's all right, but can you get the next one positioned correctly? So we're almost suggesting it's actually better on the inexpensive LED strip, maybe, than the larger tip.
The problem is the Osram has, it's not a problem, it's a good thing. It has lots of copper. So yes, you need more heat. This, as we saw in that other video, again, check out another one we have on this.
There's not many of the Earth's resources been buried into this LED strip. I would suggest copper was very thin. Right, give us a second. Yeah. We're coming back in. We want to see whether you fluked it the first time. So let's have a look.
Let's see the comments on the shakes and everything.
I'm shaking as well, so I'm not really helping here.
There we go, job done.
Let's have a little look at that. Well, as always, it's only if it illuminates.
All right, I've got to be careful here because this is 12-volt LED tech.
Oh yeah, so let's not punch. There is a video on that as well, where we look at the pros and cons for using 24-volt and 12-volts, and we discuss where both of them come into their own, don't we, in that video as well. That was a question asked to us, and we answered that question as part of this series.
We're ready.
I'm ready. Oh, wow, it's better to be lucky, isn't it, as always? Yeah. Okay. I wouldn't leave that on too long because...
No, you shouldn't do that either, but that works. So, I like that iron, actually. I mean, that's as I say, we'll probably have a few different tip sizes for different jobs and a different holder,
But we pulled that out of the box. You know, you've had to come in almost, you know, first attempt to see if you can do that with no real practice. You can only get better by practicing and knowing your own tool. You've had this, you said 50 years, you've had it, you were about 12 when you got it, so.
Yeah, when they first discovered lead, this was the second invention they made. What I would say on this, a little bit of research on that, you can actually, I'm led to believe this has got open source software in it, you can actually put your own logo.
Oh, wow.
On the display.
Pimp it up.
And chip it so it goes to an even higher temperature. It goes to 400 degrees, but I think you can go beyond that. So if you're an expert on there, let us know if you can chip it and put your own logo on there. Put the eFIXX one on and send it to us if you're really good.
That would be good, wouldn't you? As always, we're interested in your comments. Have you got a favourite soldering iron? Have you used the ST100? Have I said that correctly?
TS100, Gary.
TS100.
Destroyer of names, yes, Gary's done it.
And as always, there'll be a link in the description of where you can find this soldering iron online, so make sure you check that out. But we're interested in your soldering tips. Have you got any top tips for soldering to LED strips? Something he still likes to call
LED tip.
Okay, yeah, we'll get over that. We're always interested in your comments, and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.